O come Emmanuel, and ransom captive Israel, that mourns in lonely exile here, until the Son of God appear. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel. O come, thou day spring, come and cheer our spirits by thine advent here. Disperse the gloomy clouds of night, and death's dark shadows put to flight. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel. O come, desire of nations, bind in one the hearts of all mankind. Bid all our sad divisions cease, and be thyself our King of peace. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to
welcome to Urban Grace on the second Sunday of Advent. Urban Grace is an ecumenical church, which means that we are a church that is not defined by our adherence to a single Christian tradition. Rather, we find our identity in sort of like the celebration and incorporation of a great diversity of perspectives from the rich Christian traditions, which is another way of saying we've got all sorts of folks at Urban Grace. And so we are a church that finds its identity and its unity through serving our neighborhood, by serving our city, through engaging with social justice programs and partnerships. We are a church that works closely with the arts community in downtown Tacoma, because we believe that God is revealed through creativity and art and song and thought. And most of all, we're a church that welcomes people exactly as they are. So no matter your church background, your race, your gender identity, your sexual orientation, your abilities or disabilities, no matter exactly what you believe, you are welcome to participate in the full life of the church today and every day. And today is quite a day. I mentioned that it was the third Sunday in the season of Advent, which is the Sunday that we focus on joy as we prepare and wait for the coming of Christ. We have this little, it's actually called Gaudete Sunday, Sunday of rejoicing. And we have a lot of joy today. We will be having our annual Christmas pageant. This year it's going to be totally different and very exciting and creative. So we're so glad to have you. The service will also look a little bit different, but you'll just see. It'll be great. Again, we are so glad to have you worship with us today. And now the Bradfords will lead us in the call to worship and the lighting of the Advent wreath.
Today we light the third candle, the candle of joy. We quit our worries by focusing the promise that we are unconditionally loved, and that nothing, sickness, failure, emotional distress, oppression, war, or even death can take the love away. We celebrate the joy of the children in our church, and we look forward to the joy of God's promises. Lord, transform our hearts that we may open ourselves to joy that is shared with all creation. Amen.
A child shivers in the cold. Let us bring
that time again.
Time for the Christmas pageant?
Not quite yet. Don't we have to do announcements first?
Nope. Just check the Facebook posts or our weekly email for details about the Christmas Eve service and meal trains for the parents of our sweet new babies.
Those are some cute babies. Unfortunately, they weren't born quite in time to play the role of baby Jesus, so we got creative. And that's a good way to let you know that today we won't be having a traditional scripture reading or sermon, and that's because the Christmas pageant is either quoting or creatively reimagining the scriptures from the first two chapters of Luke and Matthew. And I think that will be way more entertaining and enlightening than any sermon that I would write. I also want to say a big thank you to our visionary children's ministry director, Jason Nicolau, who oversaw the pageant, Amanda Sermon, who edited it, and all the folks who volunteered to record scenes and music. And with that, it's that time again!
Time for the
2020 Urban Grace Virtual Christmas Pageant.
How does an innocent baby born of a virgin mother with a poor father, a carpenter, starting to see spirits and angels still smile? When the angel broke the news that his fiancée was with child, but how?
Could this have happened? How could this couple have a baby and they didn't plan it? One day this genie got the word and he couldn't stand it. Pulled out a hit to kill the baby, but he couldn't have him. Baby's savage.
Mary and Joseph noticed that they had to roll, trying to find a room in a telly, but they kept telling no. Vacancies, the spaces were taking, her water's breaking, though. Looking all around town, but there's no place to go.
But little did they know all along that God had a plan to come down to this planet in the form of a man. Starting off as the baby somewhere around midnight. No nurse, OBGYN, or midwife presence.
Only Mary and Joseph and animals from the farm. Please keep that baby safe, please keep them from harm. Tucked away in a manger under the brightest star. Tell the world your name, yeah, tell them who you are.
Jesus Christ of Nazareth. His name is Jesus Christ of Nazareth. And there's a million things he hasn't done. But just you wait, just you wait.
And the Virgin touched for the very first time. And the
Mary, you are the chosen one. Soon you will have a baby boy. He will be very special. He will be the Son of God, and you must call him Jesus.
What do you mean? I can't get pregnant. This is impossible. This is freaking me out.
Mary, don't freak out. Nothing is impossible with God.
Okay, I won't freak out, but you know who will. The man I'm supposed to marry, Joseph. Well, you said God sent you?
That's right, God sure did send me. I told him you'd freak out, but God was all like, don't worry, she'll trust me and stuff like that.
Okay.
Okay, what?
Okay, I'll trust you, but somebody else has to tell Joseph.
Joseph was truly conflicted. He wanted to marry Mary, But after finding out that she was pregnant, he was scared, confused, and didn't know what to do. He began to think he should divorce her quietly because he was afraid of what people would think. After some time thinking about this, he eventually fell asleep, and while he was dreaming, an angel paid Joseph a little visit.
What? Joseph, stop chirping. The baby that Mary is carrying is conceived by the Holy Spirit. That means that God put the baby inside her belly. Miracle! She'll have a baby, and you will name him Jesus. One day, he will save the world. By the way, stop caring about what other people think about you. God always has a bigger plan.
What's an angel? Thanks for telling me in my dream. I trust you. Okay, peace out.
Joseph, no longer confused, married Mary and happily awaited the birth of their son, whom they were to name Jesus.
Just as Joseph and Mary were getting ready to welcome baby Jesus, King Herod made an announcement.
By order of the Emperor Caesar Augustus, everyone must return to the place they were born and pay a special tax.
This meant that Mary and Joseph had to travel to his hometown of Bethlehem. After traveling for a long time, they finally reached Bethlehem.
And the lovely couple was off to Bethlehem to see if they could find a room at the inn.
Welcome to La Quinta Inn! Unfortunately, the signage was on discount. What can I do for you?
I need a room for my lovely wife.
Let me see what we have. No. Will it only be the two of you?
No, there's gonna be some shepherds.
Excuse me, are you okay?
No.
Who else would be coming?
Shepherds and some Zagastrian priests and livestock. And she needs to give birth to the savior of the world and stuff.
Special birthing accommodations? Let me think.
No room at the inn for Joseph and Mary, they made their way to the outskirts of town and found a little stable. And it was there, sometime in the night, surrounded by animals, that they would welcome sweet baby Jesus into the world.
Shine it, the ever. While Jesus was being born in a manger, there were shepherds in the fields nearby watching over their flock. An angel appeared to them, saying, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in clothes and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God.
I'm Gold. I'm the big boss.
I'm Myrrh. I'm the funny one.
My name is Frank. I don't know them.
Wise men, we should go find the king.
No, you should go find the king. Burn!
Guys, was that a very wise thing to say?
You're right, Gold. That wasn't a very wise thing to say indeed.
I just want to make sure you know your part in this whole thing.
Cool, but since I'm the funny one, can you call me the wise guy? See what I did there?
He's doing it again.
Murray, you just earned yourself another 15 miles without a donkey.
They're actually called camels, you know, with the humps.
Can you find the king already?
No, you can go find the... Never mind, let's go.
What brings you wise men to my palace?
Hey, we found the king.
Good job, Myrrh. Anyway, King Herod, we're here to ask about the baby who was born in Bethlehem and he'll be the king of the Jews.
What? I'm the king.
Sorry. But actually, the new king was born in this town of Bethlehem. And there's a huge fight over where he is.
You know what you can do for me? Find this baby and then come back and tell me where he is. I'd like to see this baby and hurt it. Wait, did I say that out loud? I'm joking. So joking. JK, just go find him.
As you wish, King Herod. Something tells me he's gonna hurt the kid. Maybe we should tell him.
Very wise, Myrrh.
Very wise indeed.
When Herod realized the wise men had outwitted him, he flew into a rage and planned to kill baby Jesus. Fortunately, an angel of the Lord appeared to Joseph in a dream.
Joseph, wake up! You're having a nightmare. Is it the one where you're not wearing pants? Is it the one where you're late for class and not wearing pants? Or is it the one where all you have is a hammer and nothing looks like a nail?
No, nothing like that, Virgin Mary. An angel came to me in my dream and told me we have to flee to Egypt because we're not safe here.
Jesus Christ.
Good point. We can't forget him.
Baby Jesus, we need to take you to Egypt where you'll be safe.
Baby Jesus, do you want to go to Egypt with us?
After some time had passed, Joseph received some wonderful news. That's right, you guessed it, in another dream.
After Herod died, an angel of the Lord appeared in a dream to Joseph in Egypt and said, "Get up, take the child and his mother and go to the land of Israel, for those who are trying to take the child's life are dead."
How do you home? How's baby Jesus doing?
He's okay. He's sleeping.
Mary, you'll never believe it. The Lord appeared to me in a dream again and told me that it is safe to return to Israel.
So Herod is dead?
Yes, but his son is reigning over his kingdom in Judah, so it's still pretty dangerous.
We should go to Galilee and stay in the town of Nazareth. And from there, our son will one day be known as Jesus Christ of Nazareth.
Let's eat!
Yeah. Nom 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 nom.
Can I have some?
How does an innocent baby born of a virgin mother with a poor father, a carpenter, starting to see spirits and angels still smile? When the angel broke the news that his fiance was with child, but how?
Could this have happened? How could this couple have a baby and they didn't plan it? One day this genie got the word and he couldn't stand it. Put out a hit to kill the baby, but he couldn't have him. Baby's a savage.
Mary and Joseph noticed that they had to roll, trying to find a room in a telly, but they kept telling no. Vacancies, the spaces were taken, her water's breaking though. Looking all around town, but there's no place to go.
But little did they know all along that God had a plan to come down to this planet in the form of a man, starting off as the baby somewhere around midnight. No nurse, OBGYN, or midwife presence.
Only Mary and Joseph and animals from the farm. Please keep that baby safe, please keep them from harm. Tucked away in a manger under the brightest star. Tell the world your name, yeah, tell them who you are.
Jesus Christ of Nazareth. His name is Jesus Christ of Nazareth. And there's a million things he hasn't done. But just you wait, just you wait. When he was born, King Herod threw a fit. Yeah, I'll mention the hit. But God, Mary, and Joseph, they were in heaven. An angel came to Joseph, said to move your family quick. So Joseph, Mary, Jesus dipped out to Egypt.
When he got older, started to shoulder all the burdens well. Bound at the synagogue by his family at the age of 12. Preaching and reaching all of the people, seeing and disbelieving. Teaching the meaning of life through God as a human being.
Aye, then Jesus chose to set it off. Got baptized and kept his eyes looking for the lost. Blowing your mind to the water, the wild, challenge the laws. Knowing the cost that one day it will take him to the cross. And I know, yeah, it was written, I'm spitting. His life, he got me getting, hitting me hard. Think about all the blood that he was dripping, tripping. It makes sense, the message that God sent. The only way to eternal life is through.
Nazareth. Wasn't that just wonderful? Good job, kids and families. Thank you so much for sharing your talents and your enthusiasm and your creativity and your humor with us. You know, at the end of last year's Christmas pageant, I had a conversation with a couple of different people saying, we wish we could have a little more of an individually showcased kind of pageant. We were getting so many kids up there on the stage, they were just getting lost. Well, little did we know, and nor would we have wished for a pandemic, but this pandemic has afforded us a new way to do the pageant, and that was outrageously successful. Good job for everybody who had a part in that. So, speaking of babies being born, I would like to know if you know that we have had over, I think, like 10 or 11 babies added to our Urban Grace Church family in the last several months. And we've got, I think, 7 more coming in the next few months. So that got the creative director of We Deliver Love thinking. And I want you to know that this last week, episode 1 and episode 2 of season 2, We Deliver Love, they were aired. And I might add, there was just a few minor changes. Like now, We Deliver Love is called We Deliver Loves. That's right. It's still We Deliver Love, but a new version. So along with truly some loves there, a nice little welcome basket goes out to each family that has had a new baby come home. And this last week, we delivered one to Charlie and her family for baby Kalani, and to Elle and George for baby Lewis. So that was super fun. We have so much to be grateful for at Urban Grace. And we normally encourage you to, during the passing of the peace, to share your text or a message with someone that you're grateful for, thinking of. And I just want to really encourage you this morning to take a minute during the passing of the peace and to write what you would be saying if you went to the coffee hour after church. We'd be in the parlor all abuzz with, wasn't that part amazing? And didn't so-and-so do so well? And my favorite part was. So I'd really like to encourage you to write those comments in the comment section this morning during the passing of the peace. It will be a real encouragement and affirmation and celebration of all of the kids and the families who put a lot of effort into this. Thank you. And now, may the peace of the Lord be with you.
And now it's also with you.
Let's share the peace of Christ with one another.
Good morning, Urban Grace. My name is Josh Carlson, and my family goes to Urban Grace. And we have a lot to be thankful for. We're thankful for the children's ministry there. We're thankful for the youth group. We're thankful for the teaching and all the diversity. Also, on behalf of the trustees, we'd all like to thank everyone that filled out a pledge card and let us know your plans to support the church in the coming year. And then also, if you haven't filled out one of those pledge cards, it is not too late. You can still do that. It helps us a lot to plan out budgets and all that kind of stuff for the next year. There's a link below the video that you can click on to do that. So let's pray for the offering. God of love and mercy, thank you so much for Urban Grace and all the work that they do. Also, during this time of holidays and family, help us to love the people around us and be present in every moment. Thank you so much for your love. Help us to give with a grateful heart. In Jesus' name, amen.
Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise Christ, all people here below. Praise Holy Spirit evermore. Praise Triune God, whom we adore. Amen.
Friends, go in peace to love and serve the Lord in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.